Hello and welcome to Fun Hunters Design Bureau. Today we are going to check out what's behind our accurate and versatile device capable of time measurement. Or simply said, it is a stopwatch that was built to be a backbone for our future projects. In order to be precise and user-friendly, this build is so sophisticated to understand that we are joining one of the chief engineers to tell us more about this incredible creation. Hello!
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 What is this? We have many zeros today. Hello and welcome to the 7 zeros episodes.
Yep. So, I'm Ike.
I'm Kicking King and we are from Fun Hunters Design Bureau.
And today we'll show you how to build a stopwatch in Scrap Mechanic.
Which will show you a lot of zeros.
Yeah, it shows a lot of zeros because every time when you start counting, you start from a lot of zeros.
A lot of zeros. Nice. Can it count like to 12?
Yep. Okay, so let me show you how to
how
it works. First, we need to start it.
Yeah, so
one push, very important. If we push it twice, it will glitch out.
Yeah, yeah, to show more zeros. Okay.
Yeah, so, because we just powered it on, we don't see it, but now it will work. And if we press this green button, and as you can see, it starts counting.
Nice, nice. What is this? Are they seconds or?
Yeah, well, basically it can count. Let me stop it again. It can count with resolution of 0.25 seconds.
This
0.025 seconds.
This is the minimum.
Which is 1/40th.
What is the maximum that it can count?
Maximum? Well, as much as you would like. So this one
like
is
like a million years.
Pretty much, if you want. So. This one, the way this is built at the moment, counts up to 60 seconds, but it is very simple to add a few more displays and counters, and as you can add as much as you want.
Okay.
So they're added over here.
Yeah.
And you can count up to 1 million if you want.
Okay. So you put them one after another and they're becoming one huge display with huge stopwatch inside it.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Okay. So measuring the time is very interesting, but how can I use this or anybody that downloads it from the Steam shop?
Glad to ask, Kiki.
Thank you.
So
I'm glad to.
There are a couple of ports over here.
Yeah.
So first one is the red one. This is for resetting.
Okay.
Basically this button.
Okay.
You have this button which is for activating the clock generator.
Yeah, starting
which
it.
Is this
yeah.
one.
Okay.
You have these three inputs ports.
Yeah. Why
so they are for different things.
Mm-hmm.
So first one, the top one is just activate and stop, nothing more.
Okay.
Activate
on off button. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Exactly on off. These two, however, are a little bit more tricky. If you connect them to buttons or switches,
yep.
Each one of those can be activated only once.
Okay.
It doesn't matter the order. So you can activate one, it will start the stopwatch,
and then the other will stop it.
The other will stop it, but if you press the first one again, it will do nothing.
Okay,
it will continue running.
So you can connect anything, like a switch, to those ports, those three ports, and this makes it very versatile for everybody. Did you know? Did you know that usability and flexibility were one of the major points while developing this stopwatch? The side panel layout gives you the ability to connect whatever input you like. And that way you can easily use it for your
own idea.
Check out the Fun Hunters idea!
Have you ever wondered how fast things are moving with Scrap Mechanic? Is it better to ride our favorite gecko truck, or is it better to go by foot? What is the difference? In this case, you are in luck, because we have the answer for you. Here's the map. Walking speed in Scrap Mechanic is 16.6 FHS, while the gecko truck tops 111.11 FHS. And by driving it, you'll be 6.69 times faster than walking. Definitely worth it. But how do we know this? For the first time in the history of Scrap Mechanic, we can determine it.
Speed.
Have you ever wondered how fast do you go? Or how fast your creations are? Or maybe you would like to compare different vehicles? We asked the same questions, and after 6 months of building, testing and documenting the results, we are proud to present our top 72 list of fastest creations in Scrap Mechanic. Check out the special episode for our FHS meter, and we are going to present speed like never before. Don't miss it out! What's the magic behind those blinking lights?
Well, glad to ask, Jimmy.
Oh.
So the magic is basically this thing over here, which is the logic. And I can show you how it works.
Oh, okay, show it to me.
Yep. Very nice. Okay, so first we start with this button. This is basically giving life to the whole machine.
Oh, this is the life button, okay.
Yeah, so what is this? Well, it's a button. It's connected to this switch, but it doesn't, to this logic gate, but it doesn't matter. The main thing is that this is connected to those both logic gates. So okay. This is a NAND gate, or it can be an OR or an XOR. It really doesn't matter.
Okay.
This one has to be an AND gate. So what happens? This one should be always on, and this one should be always off. When you press the button, it will activate this one, but it will also deactivate this one.
Okay.
And as soon as this one is deactivated, the AND will stop work. And the speed which it takes to get from the signal from here to here, and to also here, is one tick.
Okay.
So what this will do, it will generate a one tick impulse.
Okay, this is called one tick generator.
Yes.
Okay.
Exactly. So this one is connected to this loop here of these four gates. So one is OR. It has to be OR because it has two signals coming in it. And it's a loop. So what will happen? You press the button.
Oh.
And you have a one impulse which is looping in here.
Okay.
And it will loop without stopping.
So the one tick generator, it brings to life.
Yeah, this loop. Okay. This is called a clock generator.
No, yeah.
It generates an impulse at regular intervals. Okay. So each one of those gates is connected to those AND gates, and they're also connected to this switch. So what this does is, when this switch is activated, it will allow for the signal to pass through these gates. So basically this is stopping and starting the measuring of time.
So this is our green switch.
Yep, exactly. This is the same green switch as over here.
Cool.
When you press it, the signal passes through here. So,
can you press it?
The next thing is, each of those gates is also connected to here, and to here. So the signal passes from this one to this one to this one and to this one, but also from this one to this one and from this one to this one. So what will happen when the signal passes through here?
Yeah.
This will be activated each time this the one thing is active.
Okay.
So it will be active for 1, 2, 3 ticks.
Okay.
So basically this is generating a 3 tick impulse.
Okay.
And it is the same for all of them.
All of them. Okay, just press the button.
Yep. Okay, pressing the button. Oh. And you can see the magic. So
shiny.
Shiny. So why do we need 3 tick impulses?
Why? Why do we need 3 tick? I was just wondering that.
Yep.
And so, I'm sure everybody was wondering that.
Yeah, so basically it is because of these devices. So these are what 3 are gates, which are 2 NOR gates and 1 XOR gate. When they are connected in a loop like this, this creates a flip-flop. Flip-flops are very good for
the beach. you can wear them at the beach.
Yeah, if you wear them, they're good for the beach. But these flip-flops, those are toggle gates. So what this will do, it will turn on and off each time it receives a signal over here.
Okay.
So every time you put a single signal here, this will activate or deactivate if it is already activated.
Why do we need this?
Because this, when you stop the stopwatch, here we start it and we stop it, we see that it remembers what is the result.
Okay, so this is like the memory bits of the stopwatch, some kind of memory.
Yes, okay. But the difference is that you need to put the signal only in one place.
Okay, so you have this for all the channels of...
Yeah, for each of those 4 channels, yes. We have 1 flip-flop.
Okay.
But there is one catch.
Oh, catch.
The only signal that this flip-flop recognizes are 3 ticks. If you put a signal which is shorter or larger, it will glitch out.
Wow.
So, and also the good thing, when you have this button here, this switch connected to those, to the ones which are active, when you press it, it deactivates them.
So this is like a reset button?
Yeah, exactly. This is the reset button.
This is like the red button.
Mm-hmm, exactly. So, what is the next thing? Each one of those gates is connected to those switches, to those logic gates.
Yep.
This one is AND, and this one is a NOR. What is the reason? Well, this one will be active if all of those are active, and this one will be active if all of those are deactive. Mm-hmm. Meaning that each time you have 4 on or 4 off, they will go over here in this OR gate and this will be activated. This will generate an impulse every 4 ticks. Every 4 ticks, it will generate a 1 tick impulse.
Yeah, which means a second.
Well, if we have 1 tick for 1/40th of a second, this will be 1/10th of a second.
Oh, so this is 1/10th. Okay, so this is very, very accurate stopwatch.
Yes,
indeed.
So, but there is one problem. When all those are inactive, this will be active. So we want to make this to pass a signal only when we count, because currently we're not counting.
Okay.
For this reason, we have this one, which is when we have the 4 on, which is the first time those 4 are on, a signal will pass through here. This is converting the 1 tick to 3 ticks. And it will go over here. This is an SR latch or a memory bit.
Oh, memory bit, okay.
So these are 3 NOR gates and 1 OR gate in a loop. So every time you give a signal to this one will be activated. And this one is connected to the reset switch, so it deactivates it. So let me show you how it works. We activate it and this one starts flashing.
No, nice, okay. I understand this one.
Yeah.
For the flashing thing.
This is basically doing so that we have a signal only after we start counting and not before.
Okay, it's like a filter, like.
Yep. So, when we have this, and we put it in a little bit more contracted space. We have this thing. Let's just put a button.
Commercial break! Are you sick of building hundreds of cubes?
Are you sick of forging gates?
Are you sick of linking them all together?
Are you sick of testing?
Are you sick of failing?
Are you sick of testing again?
Are you sick of failing again and again and again? Fun Hunters Design Bureau already built this sophisticated but easy to use stopwatch. Stop banging your head in your creation. Stop wasting your time. We know how you feel. That's why we want to share this creation with you. Log on to the Steam Workshop. Search for Fun Hunters Stopwatch. For all this creation, cut the hard stuff. Enjoy the game. It's completely free. No charges. No taxes. As easy as a few clicks. So, what are you waiting for?
Okay, so we have these buttons here. Let's stop it. And when we start it... we didn't power it on.
No, not yet.
First, we have to activate the loop. So, then we start it. And here it is. And the signal is passing from here to over here. This is the counter. These are SR latches which are connected one to each other.
Yes.
So the next one, every time a signal passes, it activates the next one and it deactivates the previous one.
Okay.
And it toggles. Here it we can say two are passing, but that is actually not just an illusion. Okay, as you can see, when it is stopped, it shows only one.
Yeah. It's like snails racing car.
Yes. So the other this answer. Is counting 1/10 of a second. These are seconds.
Yeah.
These are 10 seconds.
Okay.
Minutes and 10 minutes. So basically, you can say count to 59 minutes and 59 seconds and 90/10 of seconds. There's just one more thing. How do you count the 40th, the one ticks?
Yeah.
You count it with this one. So depending if how many of those are activated, we have a logic here counting this. So basically it is counting, this is for 0, this is for 25, this is for 50 and 75. And again.
This is 75% of a millisecond.
It is 1/4 of 10th of a second.
Yeah, okay. So you can link this to other display.
Yeah, when you put a display over here, which is like this one,
yep,
it will display the numbers. So basically each one is of those logic gates which is active is connected to those lamps here, and it shows only the lamps activated for the specific digit.
Yeah.
And as we can see, is displaying digits like this. So that's it.
Thank you, Alex, for this presentation. Every time I see how this works, I'm just mind blown and amazed. And guys, if you think the same way too, please leave a like for the great job he did. You can check other episodes and playlists in the channel, where a lot of interesting stuff is waiting for you to enjoy and have fun with. And why not visiting our Patreon page, where you can find some inside info, have a peek about future episodes, and even support us. Thank you and see you next time.